All right, so I just recently found out about this new Linux distro called Garuda Linux. It's based on Arch Linux and it looks pretty incredible. So I figured I would test it out to see if it runs as good as it looks, and I'm genuinely interested to find out if it holds up to like the promise of being an Arch-based distro, which means that it should be pretty smooth, pretty fast, plus have access to like the widest selection of Linux packages of any distro. So let's test it out. All right, so now we're gonna find out how the installation process of installing Garuda Linux actually works. And I hope, or from what I've heard, it's supposed to be super smooth and really easy, so I hope that's the case. But you never really know with these sort of things. Sometimes they turn out to be a lot more difficult than you thought they were gonna be. But we'll see about that. What I'm really interested to find out though is whether Garuda Linux is actually better than to basically install something like Ubuntu or Fedora and some of those like more well-known distros, and then basically just install the icon pack or the icon theme that Garuda Linux is using. So yeah, that'll be interesting to find out, but now let's install it. Okay, to start off we have to install it, and the way that I did this was by using Etcher to put the distro onto a USB stick, then plug it into my laptop and boot it up into BIOS. And the thing with my laptop is that I already have Xubuntu and Windows running and taking up the entire disk space. So I had to redistribute this so that I would be able to actually have space to install Garuda. Okay, so the way that they solved that problem of the partitioning of the different OSs that I already have on this device was actually super smooth, which was really good. Well, at least if you're doing it with Arch Linux, it can be kind of difficult. Okay, so Garuda Linux is based on Arch Linux, and I've said that I wanted to find out if Garuda will hold up to the promise of Arch. So what does that actually mean, and what is actually so good about Arch? Arch Linux is the do-it-yourself distro, and with regular operating systems, when you install them, you're presented with a neat user interface with buttons to press and prompts telling you what's happening. With Arch, you don't really get that. You get a text-based interface where you manually install everything that you want. So compared to regular operating systems where you'll get a ton of software installed that you never really use, which is known as bloatware, compared to this, Arch allows you to control pretty much everything that gets installed, which means no bloatware. And less bloatware also often means that the system runs a little bit smoother, since every program that's installed usually takes up resources. However, the Arch way is quite difficult and prone to errors, which, if you're not familiar with Linux systems, these errors can be quite difficult to solve. So that means that Arch is known as a sort of elusive distro that's reserved for the more elite Linux users, which has prompted the almost meme culture of "I use Linux, by the way," being like a medal of honor, more or less. Another really great thing about Arch is something that I mentioned at the start of this video, which is that it has the widest support for Linux packages of any distro, which means that if you want some sort of tool in Linux, it's basically going to be found for Arch, which is not the case to the same extent, at least with Debian-based or Fedora-based distros. And the main like big con of Arch Linux is that it's really difficult to install. It's like almost known to be difficult to install. And Garuda is Arch based, but it boasts like a super easy installation process. So basically solving like the main big issue with Arch Linux. So this is something that's not new, I should say also, because there are other distros that do this as well. But yeah, that's basically the reasoning behind why I'm excited to try out Garuda. It's like all of the pros of Arch Linux and none of the cons. That sounds pretty good, right? But I suspect that it won't be that easy. All right, so now I have Garuda Linux installed on this machine, and I've also had the chance to play around with it for a couple hours.
And so far, my first impression of it is that I really like it. I think that the UI especially is really nice. And I also found it pretty snappy and quite responsive, so no problems there, which is something that I heard could be an issue with this particular distro. So that's really good. For now, it's been pretty good, but this is something I haven't had the chance to actually dig into it and like really try it out. So what I'm thinking that I'll do is I'll actually like commit to using this distro as my main distro for the next week. And a week is going to be plenty of time for me to actually change my mind. Right now, I feel like I like this distro, but we'll see how this develops throughout the next week. I'm going to test it out and we'll see what happens.
Oh, hi Mark. This video is sponsored by Bright Data. Programmers and coders all need a reliable data collection network for data sourcing that provides clean, accurate, and traceable data, and that helps automate and streamline the information that you need directly into algorithms and operational teams. Bright Data helps you automate this process. And with Bright Data, you can create a custom collector in minutes, and the data collection is dynamic and responsive to changes on the target site, ensuring high success rates. You get the ability to control frequency, collection window, and delivery time. And if you don't know exactly how to get started, Bright Data has a team of data collection experts that will help customize a crawling solution to your specific business needs. Data Collector delivers reliable, accurate, and clean data sets that enable you to streamline AI and ML output so that you can provide meaningful value for your customers and drive significant ROI for your company going forward. I highly recommend checking it out. There will be a link in the description. And we've created a special deal where if you deposit $100, Bright Data will match that and give you a $100 bonus. So I definitely recommend checking it out. Again, there'll be a link in the description.
All right, so now I've been trying this thing out, this distro, not this laptop, for the past week. And so what is my final verdict? My final verdict of it is that I think that it was really good and I've really enjoyed using it actually. And this is something that was sort of a surprise to me because when doing the research, I found it was a little bit like hit and miss. Some people really liked it and some people thought that it was like buggy and laggy and super bloated. And now after having used it, I feel like these two categories of people, the people that liked it and the people that didn't. Basically, the people that didn't like it, I think, are like Arch purists. They come from having used pure Arch, which means that they're like used to the idea of like installing everything themselves and knowing exactly what goes into their machines. And to a person like that, I feel like, yes, this would probably feel bloated because it does come with some pre-installed software. And I think that on the other spectrum of that are the people that come from like the more common distros, which is like the Debian-based, Fedora-based, Ubuntu stuff, like things like that, that are really common. And I think to them, they won't really feel a difference because I didn't really feel a difference and I'm one of those people. So I think that compared to like Ubuntu or something like that, you won't really feel a difference. It will be pretty much the same. And if you're an Arch purist, then yes, I think you will feel like this is bloated and you feel like this is not what you want. But as an Arch purist, you're probably not the like main person that should be looking at this sort of distro. So I think that the Arch purists out there will be bashing Garuda, and I think that the Fedora or Debian based users will find it like pretty much the same as what they're used to, or either a little bit better or at least not worse.
The thing is that you can install the KDE desktop on most distros and then just install the icon theme called Suite in the settings. And then your distro will look and also should feel the same as Garuda. So the real question that I think you should be asking is if you want to be using an Arch-based distro or a Debian or Fedora-based, etc.
That's sort of the key, and the way that I think that you should be thinking about this is that Arch is for you if you like the idea of spending considerable amount of time learning about each and every package that you install and the ins and outs of how your system is configured. Because one of the big differences between Arch and the more beginner-friendly distros is that with Arch, you pretty much have to do everything yourself. If you install a package on Debian-based or Fedora-based distros, for instance, then they will take care of installing all the extra stuff that you need to get the thing that you are installing to actually work. This means that sometimes things will be installed on your machine that weren't necessarily needed for you to be able to actually work with this particular package. On Arch, on the other hand, when you install something, you pretty much only get that thing, which sometimes means that when you go to run it, it won't work straight away because you'll need to install more stuff. And this extra stuff is stuff that Debian-based distros would have already assumed that you wanted and already installed out of the gate.
And some people would love to spend the time to just dig deep into their system and learn about each and every package that they install and like all the supporting software and just being able to really control everything. And I think that these are also the people that really become like Linux experts. But I also think that there's the other group, which is the more probably more common group, which is, are the people that just want things to work. They don't want to be bothered to have to figure out what to install to get the thing that they want to install in the first place to actually work. And I'm sort of part of the group where I really like the idea of being the person that wants to dig deep into these things, and I find them quite interesting. But generally, I will find myself just not having the time to actually dig deep into those things, and I'll lean towards being the person who just wants things to work. So because of this, I think that Garuda is really great for people like me who want to just start playing around with Arch Linux, but who don't necessarily have the time to commit to fully using Arch as like their main distro. So I'm actually going to keep this partition on this laptop because I really found it super useful. I think whenever I have time for it, I have the chance to actually play around with Arch Linux, which is really good. And overall, I really recommend trying it out. If you've felt this sort of allure of Arch Linux for a while, then I think that Garuda is really great for that. And so I think that actually Garuda has the potential to become like the gateway drug to Arch Linux for a lot of users. So yeah, that's my overall verdict. All right, so I thought I would start this new thing where at the end of each video, I will end it with like a utility boost. And the name of that is not final. I don't know if I'm actually gonna call it that, but for now we're gonna call it a utility boost, which will essentially be where I will share a resource, some sort of utility that's been very useful for me for this week and that I think you will find super useful. And it will also be a boost of some kind, or like a praising or commending of someone else's content, someone else's channel. And this week's utility boost will be of Linux Lexus channel, where I actually did some of the research for this video and where I also found some of the inspiration for actually making this video. And I really enjoy his content, and one of the videos I watched recently was about Fedora Linux, I think it was the 32 update or something, and I really enjoyed that video. I thought it was really well put together, and so I highly recommend checking his channel out. And yeah, that's it for this week's utility boost. Let me know what you think of it. I hope that this could be a really good way for me to share some content that I enjoy personally and something that I think will be useful for you, and to simultaneously be like commending or praising or boosting or whatever word you want to use for it, someone else's content who I think is doing great things. So yeah, that's it for this week's video, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope I'll see you in the next one.